Hi, I'm David Gwill. I have built a 40-node Raspberry Pi supercomputer, which I intend to use for distributed software development and testing.
So this is a perfectly functional Raspberry Pi cluster. I have four Raspberry Pis, I have a router, I have all the network cables necessary to link them together, and I have power equipment to power them all. While it's a functional cluster, it could be used for software testing. It's not what I wanted to create. It's not very sophisticated. I really wouldn't want to have it sitting on my desk for several years. This is my Raspberry Pi cluster. It is housed in a custom laser-cut acrylic case, which I designed myself and cut on the CNC laser cutter here at Dallas Makerspace. It has 10 cards, which each hold 4 Raspberry Pis for a total of 40. They are wired with network cables down to this network equipment down here, which consists of 2 24-port switches and a wireless router. There's some power equipment here, which powers the Raspberry Pis. That power equipment is powered by this ATX power supply here, which is easily replaceable should it fail. There's also an array that will hold up to 12 hard drives. Currently, it is populated with 5 hard drives, which are 1 terabyte each. These hard drives have USB converters, so they can be wired into the Raspberry Pis. Now, this is the side of the case. The front of it is here. This is what it looks like. There's the power switch here for turning it on. There's some cable management here that you can see. I actually spent a lot of time figuring out the cable management, how it should work. There are clips that hold the wires in place when they're not being worked on. There are some jacks here for wiring into the internal network. Here on the front, this side over here has 4 140mm fans for keeping the whole system cool. These actually pipe the air through 2 filters, which will keep it from getting dusty inside. And here's what the back looks like. You can see the ATX power supply here where you would plug it in. This looks a lot like a standard case in a lot of ways, except for the lack of little places to connect things here. And I have an uplink port for the router here and a gigabit port should I decide to plug something into it that needs a gigabit port. I'll plug it in now, show what that looks like. So when it's turned on, there are a lot of lights inside this. There are approximately 330 LEDs inside this case with the Raspberry Pis and the fans and everything. Most of them will not be on in this video because there's no software running on this yet, but there will be soon, and it will be an interesting sight when it's running. And let's turn the lights out now to show what it looks like in the dark. So from the front, it looks like that, of course. We'll turn it toward the side. These lights are pretty much all red right now, but the lights on the Raspberry Pi cards should light up, and there should be some blinking going on when software is running on it. And the link lights and everything will light up when there's software running on it too, on the switches, I mean. So the back looks pretty nice too, but it's really just the 4 fans lighting up. Now, let's get the lights back on. The 4 Ethernet jacks in the front are there so you can plug other systems into it. So if you want to, say, plug a really fast system into it to test load balancing algorithms, it's there for that. That's all I have for now, but I'll be posting other videos about this project and other projects that I'm working on. If you're interested in this kind of thing in general, feel free to subscribe. And thanks for watching.